9925. So Pelletti is the low woman at the moment, and this could really tighten it up. Kritzinger got a 9-7 on beam, but Alabama's floor scores are outstanding. Ashley Miles, here she goes.
Now watch.
No,
double layout. When you tumble high, you are way up there.
She was the Southeastern Conference floor champion last year as a freshman. Come on, other things. How much does the crowd help you here?
Oh, immensely.
Go higher, jump farther?
Absolutely. Especially on an event like this. Balance beam, you kind of have to learn to control it.
Right.
Still get, you know, pumped up by it, but you got to keep everything in check. Here, you can let it all go.
Fourth rotation, Alabama has made its move. Fans want a 10 for Ashley Miles. Miles gets a 9.95. 9.95 for Ashley Miles.
Crowd's not happy, but that's right. It's what she should have gotten. A great routine, very, very powerful tumbler. Look at the straight body on the double layout. Easy. Georgia consistently, or Alabama consistently does very clean, nice routines, and they're really adding some power and dynamics to the routines as well.
Georgia, as we mentioned, was in trouble on the beam. This is Marlene Stevens. Missed the landing. And then Bird with a big, now check that. That's Kritzinger. Kritzinger with the stumble. She may have hurt herself. So Stevens with a 9.175. Erickson with a 9.25. And let's pick up Kinsey Rowe. They need a big score right from Kinsey.
Well, I hated to see that stumble from Corey Kritzinger. She had a sprain, a high sprain of her ankle coming into this, and it only trained 3 days. And only competed in balance beam here, so that definitely hurt. Kinsey Rowe, it's such an exciting gymnast to watch, particularly on uneven bars and balance beam. Been a very steady performer for Georgia throughout her whole career. And like all the Georgia seniors, just want a team title before they leave.
Unofficially, Alabama has registered a 49-6, a 49-6 on floor. So Rowe needs to hit here.
Some of the mistakes they've made. And their next competition is against number one UCLA, so they probably want to do it quick.
So Rowe gets the 9-9. They throw out Stevens, but they have to keep Bird at 9.375. Well, Georgia had the lead after three rotations, but the Bama Crimson Tide has been sparkling. Have they taken over the lead? Stay with us. We'll find out after this. along with Kathy Johnson Clark. I'm Chris Marlowe. Alabama, outstanding on floor. It's fourth best all time in an apparatus. Crimson Tide takes the lead. Georgia, Oklahoma moving up into third. Denver, Florida, and Oregon State. Now Florida and Oregon State. Alabama and Georgia have the byes. Alabama will be on vault, Florida on bars, Denver on beam, and Oregon State on floor exercise. So we'll start with the Alabama senior, Warren Holdifer.
Warren was a member of that 2002 championship squad, so he has a taste of that. Been an excellent part of Alabama gymnastics, now in her senior year. Been very, very steady on vault and floor.
She had her career best 9.85 at the Southeastern Conference Championship.
Two perfectly stuck vaults preceding her. Just a little too much adrenaline and boom. You got to open up out of this pipe right here. Boy, she's high enough, rotation enough. She needs to throw a half twist on that. Get a 10-0 start value, easier to land.
Holdifer third in the six-person rotation. Gina Rice led off the vault for Alabama. Let's take a look at it. It scored some good numbers.
This was fantastic. She has such a beautiful presentation again. Boom! Arms up. Very pretty.
9.925 for Rice. And then Dana Folletti, the sophomore from Chesapeake, Virginia, would go next.
Another look at Gina's first. Look at that. Just sticks those feet in the mat and does not move.
Folletti got a 9.8. Holdifer a 9.625. And so ready for Dana Pierce, the sophomore from Advance, Indiana. As a senior, I bet you didn't know she was voted Miss Congeniality.
I did know that.
You did know that? You saw that?
I did, actually.
Can she stick the landing, though?
Whoa! And that's a nice vault for Miss Congeniality. It was beautiful.
She's got a big smile.
Won't get quite the huge score because it wasn't as big in terms of dynamics. Watch where she finishes the somersault and the twist, but her legs are nice and tight together. A little bit of pike in that position, too, but a good landing. And that always counts for something.
The only freshman to compete in every meet a year ago for Sarah Patterson. And we're set for the junior, Alexis Prion. So Alabama energized by some great performances on floor, and they've carried it over to the vault.
Boy, when momentum swings, it
sure does. Alabama's dual meet record a year ago, 10-7-0, 4-2 in the Southeastern Conference. They won the Southeastern Conference Championship with a 197.575. Pierce got a 9.875. And Brion set to go.
And she was an All-American last year after taking most of the season to recover from ankle surgery. Still came back. All-American status. See why. Very powerful. There's that front pipe with a half twist. That makes it worth a 10.0, adding the half twist to the vault.
The half twist really makes that vault. It's a little bit unusual.
Frankly, it makes it easier to try to stick. You can see the landing as it comes. It just adds enough difficulty to raise that start value score to a 10.
Alabama's vault scores so far have been very, very good.